Hello everyone, I, Dr. Ankita Karole, lecturer in physics, Government Polytechnic, Nagpur. This video is about environmental friendly light emitting diode lights and its carbon footprint. To fulfill the task held by International FDP on Environment and Sustainability by D.Y. Patil College of Engineering, Nagpur. In week 1 video, I discuss about environmental awareness about solar panels, solar cells, which is a sustainable green energy to protect our environment. Contents in week 1 video are need of solar power, production of solar power by using solar panels, solar cells, working of solar panels, effect of solar energy system power plants on environment. In week 2 video, I discuss about environment friendly light emitting diode lights and its sustainability. Contents in week 2 video are environmental friendly LED lights, energy efficiency and energy cost of LEDs, environmental impact of LEDs, sustainability of LEDs, LED standards and regulations. After learning through video, students will aware LED standards, regulations and its carbon footprint. Compare advantages of LED over incandescent lighting. Know energy efficiency and energy cost, light output of LEDs, and also understand sustainability and environmental impact of LEDs. LED standards and regulations. As the general lighting landscape continues to evolve, LED lighting for general illumination is being adopted as a viable alternative to traditional lighting due to its unique characteristics and its energy savings potential. Now, technologies require new standards and testing benchmarks. Why standardization and regulations? From an industry perspective, standards and regulations provide a platform for consistent language in regard to definitions, test methods, laboratory accreditation, and for product design, manufacturing and testing. From a governmental perspective, regulation helps ensure public safety, provides consumer protection, regulates energy consumption and monitors environmental issues. Standards are voluntary and regulations are mandatory. ISO means International Standard Organization. Industry bodies for LED standardization in US, professional associations, standard organizations, trade association, government agencies, DOE, Department of Energy, Energy Star Program, EPA, Environmental Protection Energy. US standard organizations, organizations that are developing LED lighting safety standards. US government regulations and LED programs, federal and local government regulatory positions. Why carbon footprints? Thinking about carbon footprints is a simple way of thinking about the ways to reduce environmental pollution, which is one of the main pillars of green productivity. By reducing our carbon footprints, each one of us can contribute to making the earth a safer and better place to live. To reduce carbon emission, we have to save electricity. Estimates suggest that almost half of our carbon footprint is due to electricity and 17% is due to lighting alone. Electricity can be produced by coal, gas or nuclear plants or by renewable sources like geothermal, hydro, solar and wind power. The carbon footprint of a household or person is directly correlated with the amount of electricity consumed and its source. Since almost 830 grams of carbon equivalents are released in consumption of 1 kilowatt of electricity, it follows that carbon emissions can be reduced if electricity consumption is reduced. Replace incandescent bulbs with LED lighting. LED lamps and tubes not only consume a fraction of the energy consumed by incandescent bulb, they have the double benefit of lasting almost forever and containing no mercury. By doing nothing except installing LEDs in the home, it is possible to reduce carbon footprint by hooking 6 tons per year. To put it in perspective, this saving of 6 tons is equivalent to reducing gasoline consumption by 700 gallons. The added benefit is that LED lights give at least 10 years of hassle-free service. Calling us some comparative advantages of LED or incandescent lighting. Incandescent bulb consume 50 watt of power, whereas LED consume 6 watt of power. Incandescent bulb use 0.05 kilowatt of electricity, whereas LED use 0.006 kilowatts of electricity. Incandescent bulb for incandescent bulb, hours of operation per day are 10, same for LED. Then carbon emission per year per lamp for incandescent bulb is 0.152083 and for LED 0.01825. Reduction in carbon footprint per lamp in tons for LED is 0.133833. Lighting carbon emission per year per household for incandescent it is 6.84375 and for LED 0.82125. And for LEDs, reduction in carbon footprint is 6.0225 in tons. Sustainability. LED supports sustainability in several ways. Lower energy consumption. LEDs use less energy than other types of light bulbs compared earlier, which saves consumer money. Low heat. Much of the energy consumed by other types of light bulbs is wasted as a heat loss. LEDs don't have this due to efficient design and lack of filament, hence less prone to fire hazard. No harmful materials used in construction. LED light do not contain any harmful chemicals or materials. Waste reduction. LEDs last long, that is, are durable, hence dead LEDs bulb find their way into the trash. Recyclability. LEDs are made of recyclable materials. Parts can be reused, repurposed and recycled. Energy efficiency and energy cost. For LEDs, lifespan is 15,000 hours, for incandescent light bulbs 12,000 hours and for CFLs 8,000 hours. LED use 6 to 8 watts of electricity, light bulbs use 60 watts of electricity and CFLs use 13 to 15 watts of electricity. LED use 329 kilowatt of electricity per year, light bulb use 3285 kilowatt of electricity per year and CFLs use 767 kilowatt of electricity per year. And This is the annual operating cost of LED light bulb and CFLs, and it is less for LEDs. Environmental impact. LED contains no toxic mercury. Light bulb contains toxic mercury. Light bulb do not contain toxic mercury, whereas CFL contains toxic mercury. Mercury is very toxic to health and environment. LEDs are ROH compliant, means ROHS stands for restriction of hazardous substances. Light bulbs are ROHS compliant. CFLs are not ROHS compliant. It contains 1 milligram to 5 milligram of mercury and is a major risk to the environment. Carbon dioxide emission lower energy consumption decreases. CO2 emission, sulfur oxide and high level nuclear waste. For LEDs, 451 pounds per year. For light bulbs, 4500 pounds per year. And for CFLs, 1051 pounds per year. This is the light output for LEDs, light bulbs and CFLs. For LEDs, it is 4 to 5 watts, for light bulbs 40 watts, and for CFLs 9 to 30 watts for 450 lumens. For LEDs 6 to 8 watts, for light bulbs 60 watts, for CFLs 13 to 15 watts for 800 lumens. For LEDs 9 to 13 watts, for light bulb 75 watts, and for CFLs 18 to 25 watts for 1100 lumens. For LEDs 16 to 20 watts, for light bulbs 100 watts, and for CFLs 23 to 13 watts for 1600 lumens. For LEDs 25 to 28 watts, for light bulbs 150 watts, and for CFLs 30 to 55 watts for 2600 lumens. Thank you for patience hearing. Thank you so much.